will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Beloved, we welcome you to another exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. We thank God for the anointing and the grace for healing in Jesus' name. The Holy Spirit manifesting what Jesus has already accomplished by the stripes which he received. I heard that years ago he received 39 stripes. And they said he used the cat of nine tails. And then someone said, don't know, but I'm just using it, that there are 39 groups of diseases on the earth. So he received one stripe for every group of diseases to bring perfect healing. Paul was very audacious when he said that the sufferings of Christ was completed in him. He suffered it for the body of Christ. He received those stripes three times. Jesus received the ones, 39 of them. All right, so I want you to understand then that what we are thanking God for, what we are believing and pronouncing, is what has already been done. Thank God that has already been done. Amen. I want to read Exodus 15, verse 23. And when they came to Marah, they could not drink of the waters of Marah, for they were bitter. This is part of the journey of the children of Israel through the wilderness. For they were bitter. Therefore, the name of it was called Marah. And the people murmured against Moses, saying, what shall we drink? And he cried unto the Lord, and the Lord showed him a tree, which when he had cast into the waters were made sweet. I wish, beloved, we would know what this tree was. There are so many intertwining of nature and the power of God, but it has eluded us. You know, before modern medicine came, everything was in the roots and the herbs and all of that. Then Satan got in it, and then God gave man modern medicine to get us away from satanic involvements. Remember growing up, one of my cousins, I believe is a cousin, and he was with us, and he got sick. He was very strong. He was a very strong man, you know, and he has a name that says the elephant is mighty, is great. And he got sick. They carried him from one teaching hospital or specialist hospital to another. And after my parents had exhausted all the attempts to cure him, they brought him back to the village. And I have this uncle that does these herb things or whatever. He went to the woods and got three leaves, mixed them together. And he kept doing this with it and massaging them. He said, now he will press some fluid out of these leaves, and he will put three drops in his nose. He said if he sneezes three times, he will recover in 3 days. If he hiccups, he will die in 3 days. Wow. He put that thing in his nose, and then the guy sneezed three times, and then he got up. And he just died like a year or 2 years ago. So there's so many supernatural things like that that we have lost. God showed Moses a tree. He said, cut this tree, throw it into the water, and it will heal the water. You know, water treatment costs in the billions. And today we are drinking the same water we flushed our feces with. And then they have to reclaim it and clean it up and bring it up for us to drink. If you think about it, you will not drink the water at all. You see? It's just an amazing thing, but God did this supernaturally. There's so much healing. So now we see a new thing now with all the herbs and the vitamins and all of that, but all these things have satanic underpinnings. It's almost like a religion. That's my only problem with these things. Yes, take vitamins for health, but don't trust in it. Trust in the Lord your God to bring healing and deliverance to you in Jesus' mighty name. So when he had cast this thing in the waters were made sweet. There he made for them a statute and an ordinance, and there he proved them. Verse 26, and said, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and will do that which is right in his sight, and will give ear to his commandments, and keep all his statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I have brought upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord that healeth thee. This scripture is so powerful because for a long time we focused on I am the Lord that healeth thee, but we miss the path into this healing, and then the understanding that he says when we keep these things, we are in a constant covenant of healing. He didn't say I'm the Lord that healed thee. He didn't say I'm the Lord that's going to heal thee. He says I'm the Lord that healeth thee. So we are called to live in a constant stream of healing. But he says there are conditions to it. The first condition, he says, you must diligently hearken unto my voice, to the voice of the Lord thy God. You must diligently hearken. So we must be students of the word. We must study the word continuously and voraciously and passionately. I remember when the Walkman came into being, people had the Walkman in their head listening to the word day and night, but it was all geared towards getting prosperous. It wasn't learning God and his ways and to manifest these things in our personal lives. It was always to gear towards the economic side of things. Well, nothing wrong with being blessed financially, but we need healing in our souls. We need deliverance from sin. We need our relationships healed. We need to be productive witnesses in the kingdom. He says, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God and will do that which is right in his sight. So the Lord needs to be looking at me and he has to see that I'm living a holy life and over time, that's in his sight. It's not just one moment, he says, and will give ear to his commandments and then keep it, the statutes. Then he says, I will not put any of these diseases upon thee. Not going to allow these things. So even when we then find that we are already sick, then we have to go back to the process. He says, listen, hearken diligently to my words, then do what is right in my sight, give ear to my commandments and keep my statutes so I can get the healing he has promised. You see? So we are teaching on prayers that prevail, but we wanted to finish, since the Lord skewed it towards healing, we wanted to finish this week dealing with it. You are the healed of the Lord. You are the healed of the Lord. Glory. You are the well that was made sick, but now you are taking back your healing in Jesus' name. God bless you. Amen and amen. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.